You've just learned how to initialize a repository and add commits to it using the staging area. So far, each commit that you've made has built upon the previous commit, creating a linear commit history. Now let's take a look at some times when you might want to make a commit history that branches out into multiple versions. Making a straight line of changes makes a lot of sense if you're just fixing bugs, adding new features, or updating documentation. But what if you wanted to try out a new experimental feature that you're still not sure will work, but you still want to have a working demo to show your friends when they ask what you're working on? Or maybe you're learning Italian and want to make a version of your project for Italian-speaking people while leaving the native language version intact. In this case, you'll probably want to eventually create a setting for switching between the two languages. But maybe as a first step, you just try changing the text and seeing if you need to rework your layout a little. Of course, you could just make your changes and record the IDs for all the commits, and then use git checkout to jump back to the real official version when you need to show it to somebody, and then back to your other version afterward. But what if you find a bug in your real official version, and you need to make a fix there? You'd need to update your records and use this new commit as your real version. This would be a lot of overhead. To make this kind of situation easier, Git allows you to create labels for your commits. These labels are called branches. In this case, we would have three different branches. First, we would have master. Master is the name given to the main branch in most Git repositories. And every time you create a repository, Git creates a master branch for you. This branch we would probably call something like Italian. And this one we might call experimental, or maybe just exp for short. Remember how in the last lesson, when you checked out some old commits, you would get the detached head message? Basically, at that point, Git was warning you that you were looking at a commit that was not labeled with a branch name. So far, you have always either been in a detached head state or on the master branch, which Git creates for you. It's possible to check out a branch in the same way that you checked out commits in the past, except with the hopefully human-readable branch name rather than an unpronounceable series of characters. If you check out a branch and then make a commit, the branch label automatically updates to the new commit. That branch also stays checked out, so you don't have to check it out again. This is how you've managed to stay on the master branch without knowing anything about branches up till this point. As a matter of terminology, we sometimes refer to the current last commit on a branch as being the tip of that branch. It is possible to have multiple branch labels attached to a single commit, but making a new commit will only update the branch that you have checked out and leave any others alone. At this point, it's natural to wonder if there's any way to combine two branches. Say if your experimental feature has finally worked out, but your main branch has grown since the two diverged. The process of combining two commits is known as merging, and we'll get to that later on in the lesson. But first, we want you to get comfortable creating, checking out, and committing to branches. Caroline will help you get started with this.